Love is like candy on a shelf. You want to taste and help yourself. The sweetest things are there for you. Help yourself, take a few. That's what I want you to do. We're always told repeatedly, the very best in life is free. And if you want to prove it's true, baby, I'm telling you, this is what you should do. Just help yourself to my lips, to my arms. Just say the word and they are yours. Just help yourself to the love in my heart. Your smile has opened up the door. The greatest wealth that exists in the world could never buy what I can give.
Savannah Hotel, please.
Hope you got your credit card.
I don't think I'll be needing it.
Careful, please.
Just help yourself to the love in my heart. Your smile has opened up the door. The greatest world that exists in the world can never buy what I can give. So help yourself to my lips, to my arms, and then let's really start to live. Just help yourself.
The gentleman said to tell you, no hard feelings.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Ready, Beatrice? Beatrice?
Yes.
Okay, credit.
Yes.
In five, four, three, two,
road
one.
Titles. From Dawlish to Dorchester, Warminster to Weymouth. Wessex Tonight brings you all the top news stories in the Wessex region.
Three, two, one.
Cue Beatrice.
Trevor Scott there with a little taste of what we can look forward to at Sturmester Newton's annual festival of cheeses.
Yes, well, I know where I'll be heading off this weekend. How about you, Beatrice?
You try and stop me, Keith.
Now, salivating at the thought.
Just stick to the script, please, Keith. And Claude, stop playing with your hair. You look lovely.
And cue Claude.
Yes, I'll have all the latest netball action. Some falconry, would you believe?
Beatrice next on camera one.
For Commonwealth Games glory.
Mix Beatrice.
But first, Lady Bird, fly away home. Your house is on fire. Your children are gone. But try telling that to the local ladybirds and they simply won't believe you.
Yes, the region's farmers are up in arms about a plague of the little critters.
Keith's very flushed tonight. Looks like he's been boiled. Do something about Keith's face, Ursula.
Stand by for BT?
Isn't there a dial or something?
Can I have silence, please?
Tony Page is our reporter on the spot.
Late on the VT there, Dom.
Oh, quiet, please!
Ladybirds, on the spot.
No, it's my...
on the spot. Guys, he wrote this script.
Ladybirds, eh? The little rascals.
Oh, and Don, the VT was late.
Yeah, my fault. Sorry, Beatrice.
I love ladybirds. How about you, V?
I have no strong feelings, Keith. Oh,
talking about ladybirds, what are you doing after the show?
Is that a segue, Keith? Because if it was, I don't understand it.
No, I just thought we might go for a pint somewhere, just
Ooh,
you and me.
Oh, I don't think so.
I know this little place does a lovely meat pie.
Oh, well, if there's a meat pie.
Well, I think we could spend some time socialising, you know, just me and you.
And how is Mrs. Fleming these days?
Oh, she couldn't manage a meat pie. Mm-hmm. Not with her medical condition.
Well, I'm very, very sad to hear
She's
that.
Wife in name only, I'm afraid. Separate bedrooms now.
You amaze me.
I just don't like the thought of an attractive, sensual woman in the prime of life sitting alone night after night.
So who are we talking about here, Keith?
Oh, I think we know who we're talking about.
Now, hero, with the weather.
Camera two, Don?
What? Yeah,
camera two, yeah.
Thanks, Beatrice. Well, it's been a lovely day all over the region. Not quite bikini weather yet, unless you're feeling very brave.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Three, two, one, and off.
I'd
Okay, thanks very much, everyone.
Keith, quick word.
Sweetheart.
If you ever touch any part of my body with any part of your body, either on air or off, or even in your imagination, then I swear I'm gonna... Is that clear?
Nice show, Beatrice. Thank you. Keith.
Mm?
I know you like to keep things free and loose, but please stick to the script. Otherwise, you tend to just talk utter, utter rubbish.
Hero, you all right?
Fine.
I just wanted to say, great weather.
Thank you, Claude.
Hero, can I just, ask you something?
Go on.
How come you just know?
What?
The weather. What's going to happen? How can you tell?
I just read the meteorological reports. Meteorological. I've real problems with that word.
Meteorological.
Precipitation, cumulonimbus, anemometer, altostratus castellanus. I tell you, if I don't have my false teeth in properly.
You've got false teeth?
No, I was just, you know, joking.
Oh, right, sorry, I don't always spot them jokes.
No, me neither. Bye then.
Hero.
Claude.
Will you go out with me? For drinks, with food or without, entirely depending on...
When?
Saturday?
80% chance of shower Saturday.
Sunday, then?
Cloudy, brightening later. Now, temperature-wise, we're looking at 23 to 24 degrees. Should be a lovely day.
So, what, you're up for it?
I thought you'd never ask.
Now this is exactly what I'm talking about, see? You got liquids, you got electrical equipment. It is literally an accident waiting to happen. Oh, smell that. An alcoholic beverage. Well, not on my watch, Vincent. Not on my watch. Hello. Mr. Fleming! I'm locking up now, Mr. Fleming. So if I can ask you please to vacate the premises?
What? Oh, yeah. Yes. That's fine. Fine.
Mr. Fleming! Everything all right there? Right.
Leonard, it's not my fault.
I didn't say it was.
How's he doing, anyway?
Well, let's just say I wouldn't buy him any green bananas.
Leonard.
If I could just see some ID, please.
I've been working here for 32 years.
Uh-huh. Right, that seems to be in order. Order, could I have a word about some health and safety issues?
Later, Mr. Berry, please. Keith's going to be fine. He just won't be coming back to work anytime soon.
That's wonderful. Sorry. I mean, that's very sad. But it does mean I get the show all to myself, doesn't it?
Yes. Until next week, anyway.
Why? What happens next week?
Well, you're going to be joined by... someone.
Someone...
Listen, B, you're not to overreact.
You haven't. You wouldn't.
I've already offered him the job.
Withdraw the offer.
He's already accepted. Starts next Monday.
Right. Well, I suggest you start looking for a new female presenter. One man, Leonard, the one man in the world you know I hate.
Hate's an awfully strong word.
Oh, all right, then. Despise, abhor, loathe.
But think of the show, Bee. It's a dog-eat-dog world in our local regional news. It's not enough to stick you on a stool with a laptop. We need that, well, that frisson.
Frisson? There is no frisson.
But you have to admit, you are a great team, Bee. And the housewives all still love him.
We call them women now, Leonard.
Women all love him.
Not all women, Leonard. Not all women. know, buy a nice new sofa or something. Oh, all right, all right. I'll think about it.
Thanks, B. If it's any consolation, I'm bringing Peter back to direct.
Well, that's something, I suppose. What about Don?
Yes, well, we're letting Don go.
You're sacking Don? Leonard, his wife has just left him.
I won't sack him. Just offer him an inferior job and hope he resigns. Stick him on graphics or something. No one likes him. He's constantly fouling up. Mr. Berry keeps finding water bottles that don't contain water, and I don't like the way he looks at my daughter.
All the men look at Hero like that. That's why you employed her.
Well, I don't like her. I swear, B, I spend 5 minutes with the man, I get heartburn.
You wanted to see me, Leonard?
Oh, yes, Don.
Examine the lost treasures you may have lurking in your loft at home. In tonight's show, Toby jugs. Now, everyone loves a Toby jug, but what's it really worth? Here in Middle Wallop, a Toby jug can... Stolen. Translators run off with the sound equipment.
I'm amazed you're still talking, Benedict. Nobody's listening to you.
Beatrice, you're still here.
So it would seem. I like this, by the way. Not many men your age can get away with that. The pirate look. Ha ha! Very striking. Sorry, I interrupted, didn't I? Go on.
So the translator has run off with the sound equipment, and the combat is getting pretty intense by now.
I caught that late night antiques thing, by the way. Late night or very early morning. Tell me, is that a pre-record or do you actually have to stay up until 4 a.m.?
It's a pre-record.
Oh.
Be surprised how popular it is with middle-aged women living alone.
Okay, if I could just have your attention, please.
Don't tell me you're at it already.
Okay, people,
oh,
quiet, please.
See you again, please.
Quiet.
You too, be lovely.
How are you? Shut up! Now, I'd just like to take a moment to welcome some old friends back to the fold. I believe most of you know Benedict. And our new director, Peter. We're very excited to have them back. And to show just how pleased, I'd like to hand over to Hero. Hero.
Oh, sorry. We've decided we're going to have a party Sunday night, Dad's house, to welcome the new team. And to make it extra, extra special, it's going to be fancy dress.
Yes, I love fancy dress.
Right then.
Don, can I have a quick word? What are you doing for lunch?
I'm really glad you decided to stay on, Don. I know being put on graphics feels like a demotion, but...
Well, it is a demotion, so...
Don. It's got to stop.
What has?
The letters, the phone calls, the flowers.
I can buy someone flowers, can I?
Not anymore, no. I'm very grateful, but Well, I'm with Claude now, and I like him very much.
But I've never felt like this about someone before. Not even my wife. You're right. Ashamed of me. That's it, isn't it? That's why we're way out here, so no one else can see us.
I've seen you outside the house, Tom. Sitting in your car in the middle of the night. It's not fair. I don't like it. It scares me.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
You can't force someone to love you, darling.
You can't force them not to either.
But you will find somebody else. I know you will. You're a lovely man.
Am I?
Of course you are.
And that night we spent together, it wasn't because you felt sorry for me.
Of course not. You're just lonely, that's all. You'll find someone else, like I found Claude, and you'll fall in love again, and then we can go back to being good friends. I need this to be our secret, okay? Well, what a lot of weather we've been having recently. Sunshine in Weymouth.
Look at her. Drizzle. The way she brings the sun in like that with a wave of her hand, it's almost like... Well, it's almost like she's making it happen for real, do you know what I mean?
You're not about to do anything stupid, are you?
Like what?
The M word.
No. Of course not. But it wouldn't be such a bad idea, though, would it?
If you say so.
You don't think she's gorgeous?
She's very nice, Claude. I just prefer something a little less obvious.
Like what? I mean, who?
I don't know. Her, I suppose.
Beatrice?
Yeah, it's a purely objective statement. It's like saying you prefer a Lotus to a Porsche.
Bit sexist, isn't it, comparing a woman to a car?
Depends on the car.
Hmm.
Well, she's a very attractive woman, Beatrice. Or at least she would be if she wasn't such a small, carnivorous dinosaur. Quick, sharp, vicious little teeth.
Mm. Velociraptor.
Yeah, exactly, a velociraptor. We were just talking about a big new fossil find in Lyme Regis, Bee. We're very excited.
Call me Bee, please.
Hope you're going to be gentle with me tonight.
Well, you're not scared.
Just over
you?
1 minute, everyone.
Well, you did nearly kill your last coprosexer.
That was justifiable homicide.
So did you miss me, then?
You were all I thought about.
Sorry, am I tugging it too hard?
You can tug harder if you want.
Oh, dear.
Do you need anything, Beatrice?
A short length of lead pipe.
1 minute, then, everyone.
Can I speak honestly?
I don't know, can you?
Because clearly you're still upset about us.
Us? Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and about the way it ended.
Nothing had started, Ben, so how could it
and,
end?
And,
honestly, the
you know, I feel bad about telling you by text. I do. But if I've left you feeling in any way undervalued...
If it wasn't so
rejected
pathetic, I swear,
in any way, then...
No,
then I'm sorry, really, I am. But we can't go on like this, Bee.
But don't call me Bee!
Everything happy in there?
Fine.
Perfect.
Thanks. Good luck, everyone. We're on in 30.
By the way, you got something in your teeth.
Oh, yes, I'm sure I do. What, spinach, right?
No, it's just a little stringy bit of meat, just there. Just
I think I'll live with it. Thank you.
OK, it's your decision. Make it a phone-in competition. Guess the presenter's lunch.
You know, it really is the oldest trick in the world.
I was trying to help, Ben, but if you don't believe me...
No,
in
I
eight,
don't.
Seven. Why don't you ask the gallery, then?
OK, I will.
Go on, then.
Yeah, fine.
Three.
Guys,
two,
I got something in my
one.
Teeth. Cut, cue, Benedict.
And I'm Beatrice Evans. Welcome to Wessex
Maybe this
Tonight.
Wasn't such
Later
a good
on
idea,
the show,
after
we'll
all.
Be going over to the Yeovil Amateur Operatic Society, who are doing a production of Hair. Bill Parrish playing the lead. 76.
Great, isn't it? I've been wearing it around a flat all day. It makes me feel powerful, you know? What am I wearing? Ooh. Two for the price of one.
You can throw this old stuff out now, Dad. Help you if you want.
I like it the way it is. Besides, you never know when you might need your room back.
Hardly likely, is it? How do I look?
Just just like your mother.
Oh, meant to be Marilyn Monroe.
I mean, you look beautiful.
Don't start, you'll make me scroll around. Oh. I'll get them.
Ta-da!
Don! You look amazing. Laura, can't you give me something?
I got to give myself one more chance. Isn't it just your uniform? Danger never sleeps, Mr. Armitage. 89% of accidents happen in a home.
You just made that statistic up, didn't you?
Would you mind using a coaster? Leaves a ring otherwise.
It's my house! I'm B!
Hello, you.
Your Majesty!
You.
All hail.
You're wonderful.
Thank
you. What's she come dressed as?
Man, by the looks of it.
Oh, Margaret.
My God, look at this place. Same old faces. Tonight they're going to party like it's 1939. Why is there never a tin opener when you need one?
Who is that? That's not Margaret, is it?
Yes, my liege.
Hello, hi.
Haven't you got sheep to look for?
That's Bo Peep, I'm Little Miss Muffet.
What are you come as?
Oh, just some sort of vaguely sexy cat. Don't ask why, there's no real logic to
it. See, Little Miss Muffet's completely different. I've got a spider.
Just some old leotard I found tangled up in my lingerie drawer.
So what's so sexy about this particular cat?
You tell me.
I did have a toy, actually. I put it...
Honour, if you would... I humbly ask you to consider... over the moon, if you... Don. Having fun?
Oh, you know me, crying on the inside. So, the boss's daughter, eh? Smart move.
What's that supposed to mean?
Nothing. Just she's a very beautiful girl, that's all. Very popular. Everyone loves your hero. Your hero. My hero. Everyone's hero. I'm gonna get a refill. Do you want anything?
What? No. No, I'm all right, thank you.
And your relationship with the camera is, well, it's like you own it. It's so much more than just the weather girl.
Well, I prefer to think of myself as a broadcaster.
You're more than that. You're a communicator.
Thank you, Ben.
Margaret's looking for you.
Where?
Upstairs in the old room.
Okay. See you later.
Bye. Ciao.
Just give it a rest, eh?
What? What have I done?
Would you excuse me, please?
Sure.
What have I done? Claude, what are you doing?
Claude? It is Claude, isn't it? Come and talk to me. Where's your sidekick then, Claude?
Sidekick?
Probably working his way through the buffet, seeing how many chicken thighs he can fit in his mouth.
What do you mean?
Well, I know they say the camera adds 8 pounds, but he's not on camera now, is he?
The ladies still seem to...
Sorry, I can't hear you, Claude. Why don't you take your helmet off?
So Benedict still seems very popular with the ladies.
Well, that's what he likes you to believe, yeah. But oh, that beard. It's like he's got food smeared all around his mouth.
Well, it's just as well you never have to kiss him then.
And for that, I thank God every day.
What'd you do if I,
Nope, you're mumbling again, Claude.
I said I'll tell Benedict what you said.
Fine, tell him. He'll just try and come back with some smart-ass remark and it won't be funny or make sense and nobody will be listening to him anyway.
Excuse me, a minute, would you?
Claude? What? Is it something I've said? Claude?
Tell you now, so you got plenty of warning. Leonard's hired a karaoke machine.
She is Satan. She looks normal, but she's Satan in human form.
Oh, what is it now?
send me some sort of signal. You know, tears for clown and all that.
I hate clowns. As if he wasn't creepy enough as it is.
Margaret, please.
I don't know how you managed it. The hot, meaty breath. That sweaty face bearing
it's
down on
white bit in the corner of his mouth.
Mm. Hey, Dom's all right. Talking and crying about how lonely he was, and I don't know, I just felt sorry for him.
And does he know that, do you think? That you slept with him out of pity? Because men love that pity sex.
I'd just like to forget about it, please. If you ever breathe a
5'8", and I'm 5'4". Not much more, and I'd have been out there now on a stakeout or something. It's bigotry, that's what it is. There is no proven connection between height and the ability to fight crime. Poirot's not a big man. Morse, he's stocky, not tall. Columbo, tiny. Absolutely tiny.
Oh, God, here she comes. The Virgin Queen. Quick, give me something to do. Do you want a refill? Do you want to get my ashtray? Do you want a smoke?
Gentlemen!
Hello. Pete, do you want a hand with you? So, nice ruff.
Thank you. How about a dance then, eh? A bit of cardiovascular.
No, I don't think so.
I'm trying to be friendly here, Benedick. This is it, me being friendly. I'd make the most of it by you.
The love of love is in your eyes.
So enjoying yourself?
Haven't had this much fun since Children in Need.
We should probably knock it on the head.
No, thanks. Stick it out to the bitter end, eh?
Touching, isn't it?
A marriage of true minds.
That misty, faraway look in their eyes.
Like conjunctivitis. Oh, glory.
Oh, hero.
Say to me those three little words.
Me love you.
Blah, blah, blah.
Blah, 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 blah.
Oh, God, here we go.
Well, at least when they're kissing, they're not talking.
Well, they're trying, though.
I can't think of anything worse than to have someone say they love me.
Me too.
Well, that's something we've got in common, then.
Not much, is it?
No, not much.
Oh, God. Is this what I think it is?
Here we go.
Let's take our lover's vow and then seal it with a kiss. I can hardly wait to hold you. Feel my just to love you now that I've found you.
I know it's a bit whirlwind and everything, but earlier on this evening, I asked Hero if she would marry me. And I'm delighted to say that she's agreed to be my wife.
Might want to give it a couple of minutes. What's going on there?
Congratulations.
Oh, I am so pleased. Of course I approve. Come here.
Well done, you.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
thanks.
I didn't see that coming, did you?
Nobody tells me anything.
G
junior hockey team faces relegation?
No.
Local steel band triumphs?
No.
Another fishing boat has vanished in the so-called Weymouth Triangle.
Completely vanished?
No, they found it again.
What about the...
Oh, Swanwich has appointed its new town crier.
No.
Oh, there's a two-headed frog being found in Langton Matravers.
That's gross.
Forget it, the other side of board of exclusive rights.
Bastard.
I love these big news days, don't you? It's like all the president's men. You could always do
it. There was a terrible fog this morning.
It's not quite a killer story we're looking for, though, is it? Fog?
I'm sorry, but I still don't know what was wrong with my story.
What was it again?
They are closing down the Lady Mead nursing home. Now, the residents are all in their 80s or 90s. A couple of them are over 100. And the council are just going to dump them in hospital wards. They're not ill, they're elderly. The whole thing stinks.
The nursing home stinks?
Looks like our lead story.
I don't know. Isn't it a bit...
What?
Worthy.
It's exactly the kind of story that's relevant to our viewers.
Look at this. Winner of this year's Miss East Dorset Beauty Contest.
Well, let's see.
Oi. Here. Might be a mid-show spot, I suppose. Proud local farmer, Clive Dobbs, and last year's winner, his lovely daughter, Rosie.
Rosie's the one with the pipe and the lazy eye.
I'm so sorry, I must have missed something. When was it decided that we had a nightly misogynist slot?
Misogynist?
Look it up, Ben. It means somebody who hates or fears women.
Hey, I don't hate women. I love women.
God save me from men who say they love women. They are the worst.
Here, here.
Yes, here, here.
Oh, it's just a bit of fun, Bea.
Fine. Have your fun. Put it on the show. Just don't expect me to present it, that's all. I'm sorry that things down here aren't proving quite as intense as you're used to. I'm sorry there's been no bloody civil war in Axminster, no great herds of dinosaurs marauding down the Newton Abbott bypass. But I happen to love this job and the people, and I happen to think it's important and worthwhile.
So do I.
And
that's
deserving
why...
of some basic respect. And if you don't agree,
do
perhaps
agree.
You better pack up your shiny suits in your plastic bag and sod off back to London.
Tell me, do you ever listen to what other people say?
If someone's worth listening to.
And how do you know I'm not?
Past experience.
Well, it must get pretty lonely, I imagine, up there on the moral high ground.
Oh, no, it's wonderful. What's it like down there in the gutter?
You snob.
You a...
prig.
Clown. Come on, Ben. Think. Faster. Faster.
You sour, cold-hearted, joyless bitch!
Right, OK. This is how it's going to go. We turn up, we do the show, we go home, and that's it. Agreed?
Fine by me.
Oh, we found the most beautiful venue.
Mm-hmm.
And the menu's been finalised.
Oh, please God, let it be salmon.
It is salmon.
Hey!
Oh. And there's something else. Claude and I have talked, and... well, we would love it if you could be our chief bridesmaid.
I see.
So, now, I know what you're thinking.
Go on.
You're thinking you're way too old to be a bridesmaid.
Yeah, that's exactly what I'm thinking.
So you could be whatever an older bridesmaid's called. Maid of honor, is it? Or matron. What is the difference? Oh, you are pleased, aren't you?
It is a dream fulfilled. But you must understand, if you throw the bouquet at me, I will throw a bottle back.
Won't take him.
Who's the best man, by the way?
I'll have to make a speech. Is that all right?
Fine. It's your funeral.
Yeah, I prefer to think of it more as a day of joy and celebration.
Oh, I know, sorry, mate. I'd love to do it, of course I would.
Thanks, mate.
1 minute, everyone!
Boys!
Bad hair day?
Bad face day.
Everybody happy here?
Fine.
Wonderful, wonderful.
What you do, you know?
I'd love that.
What do you think of this one? Do you think it's a bit much?
Maybe something a little plainer.
Mm-hmm. A noose, perhaps.
Okay, stand by studio. 10 seconds for the opening item.
You know, sometimes I think you're just a little bit jealous, that boy.
You really do put the W into Anchorman, don't you? Good evening.
I tell you, I don't get paid enough for this, Leonard.
Must be something you can do, Pete.
Me? Why are you asking me? I read it, Roe VT.
You're the director.
In 3, 2, 1.
And Roe VT. Okay. I'll think of something.
Good.
This is the 6 o'clock news.
from the BBC with Benedict Taylor. Hello and welcome to Newsnight. I'm Benedict Taylor.
You know, in many ways I blame myself. I shouldn't have invited him back knowing how she feels about him.
You want to know, Dad?
No, it's my fault for meddling. I thought perhaps if I put them back together, he'd finally see what a fathead he's been. But now the whole future of the show's in jeopardy. Odd you won't.
Right positions, everyone.
Same as she said to you, that she loves him more than life itself.
How strange, when outwardly she appears to dislike him so much.
That's just a front.
No, trust me, she worships him. It's all she ever talks about.
I see. So her apparent hostility is just a persona which she assumes to hide the romantic nature of her true feelings towards Benedict.
So why hasn't she said something?
What's the point? You know what a clown he is. He'll just laugh at her and bang on about how he needs his space.
I love Ben, but at the end of the day, he's just not that bright.
Well, I think he's mad not to see it. She's smart, she's funny, she's incredibly intelligent.
About everything except loving Benedict.
She's very sexually attractive.
Good.
No, no, it's true. She's a beauty.
I tell you, if I was 5 years younger...
5 years?
What was that? Is there...
someone out there?
No, there can't be. So, what are we going to do?
Well, we've got to do something. Ooh. I mean, she's drinking all the time. Every time I hear it. What am I going to do? I love him so much.
I hear she's thinking about leaving the show.
No, she can't do that. The ratings are up. The viewers love them.
But she's very, very unhappy, Leonard. I wouldn't be surprised if she hadn't... No, it doesn't matter.
No. Go on.
If she hadn't been thinking about doing something stupid.
Well, that's it. I'm gonna have to tell him.
No, you mustn't. She'd rather die than show how she truly feels.
So what do I do?
Well, just wait and hope that he comes to his senses.
She loves me. Now come to think about it, it does make a kind of sense. The hostility and everything. Oh, that's why we can never be friends. It's just too painful for her. Well, I suppose I'll just have to love her back. Yeah, there'll be some fun at my expense, of course. But a person's allowed to change his mind as he matures. Love's just one of those things a man grows into, like jazz and olives. And I'm not going to let a few sarcastic remarks change the way I feel. After all, the world must be peopled. When I said I'd die a bachelor, I just didn't realise I'd live this long. And there's no denying the fact that she's a very attractive woman. Talented, funny, kind. Well, she's not kind, but she's so smart, so intelligent. About everything except loving me.
Could I see some identification, please? Yeah.
Hey, I don't suppose you've got a bicycle pump I could borrow.
The trick is not to change my behaviour. Not to appear proud or arrogant about the fact that she's obsessed with me.
The trick is to be very, very cool, suave about the whole thing.
Who is it?
It's me.
Just making myself decent.
Can I wait that long?
Can I wait that long?
You're incredible, really, you are.
Leonard says due to Hero's hen party, the debrief's been cancelled.
Beatrice, thank you so much.
For what exactly?
You know, making the effort.
If it had been any effort, I wouldn't have bothered.
Well, still, thank you very much all the same.
You feeling all right?
Of course, why?
You're sweating more than usual. And that smell.
They're just aftershave.
Smells like a photo lab. What do you actually do in there, anyway? It's not a woman, is it? Come out, sweetheart. Don't be ashamed.
What would I be doing with another woman?
Benedict, I don't care. You can do what you like.
Oh, right. I see.
What's that look supposed to mean?
What look?
That look.
Oh, nothing. Nothing at all.
Are you smoking crack?
No, you know, just high on life.
Oh, my God. I am horribly in love with her.
You do know there's a large blue ball hidden in your wardrobe, don't you?
I'm decent now.
I think I'll be the judge of that.
1 minute, please. Can I do you now, sir?
No, thank you, Margaret. I think I managed by myself today.
Right. Fine.
Tell me, do they give you a clothing allowance?
Of course.
Do you spend it on men? It can't all go on scotch eggs and lager.
You're absolutely right. This tie's awful, isn't it?
Oh. Right, that's not it, is it? I say something mean to you, you say something mean to me, and then we go on from there until you can't think of anything else to say. Those are the rules.
Well, perhaps I've had enough of playing games.
What is that supposed to mean?
I think you know.
Freak.
I'm live on air.
Good evening.
Good evening.
And right, left.
I don't know about you ladies, it's like patting your head and rubbing your tummy, isn't it? Trying to... Now, you see, my hips have gone all wrong now.
They say belly dancing is great exercise. Well, I can't vouch for that. What I can say is that I am completely exhausted.
Four, three, two... No.
Back to the studio.
One. Cut and shoot.
Things I do for this show.
Wareham Women's Institute there, proving that it's not all about jam making.
Now, if any of you are still watching out there, it's time for Hero.
You were tremendous, by the way, the way you move.
Well, thank you, Benedict. That's it's very kind of you. Now,
no, really, you shouldn't put yourself down. You were wonderful, wonderful, way better than the others. That's my feeling, anyway.
Hero, weather.
Thank you, Beatrice. Now, we've had some lovely photos sent in of the sunset tonight, but if you're thinking about getting your barbecue out this weekend, then I think again. That's right, there's only one word for the weather this weekend, and that word is very changeable.
We need to talk.
Can it wait until I got my trousers on?
No. We can't go on like this.
I completely agree.
You are driving me crazy.
Well, if you let me get my trousers on...
I'm serious, Benedict.
No, I'm serious too.
You've been making my life an absolute misery.
Well, I know. But I'm sorry.
If I'd known how you felt, Bea.
Don't call me Bea. Now, look, we need to sit down, get this all out in the open, and see if we can come to some sort of mutually satisfying arrangement.
Arrangement?
Yes, an arrangement.
Well, okay, I wouldn't have put it quite as clinically as that, but, well, if you want to fix a date...
Well, what's wrong with now?
Now?
Yes, now, right here. Let's do it right here.
Okay, but shouldn't I, don't know, buy you dinner or something first?
What?
Or we could go to your place.
My place?
Yeah, or a hotel.
Why do we want to go to a hotel?
It'd be a nice hotel.
No, no. No, not tonight, then. There isn't time now. It's Hero's bloody hen night. I'm Mother Hen. I'm going to hell in a stretch limo.
Well, don't go.
I got to go. Somebody's got to carry all the sex toys.
Look, I'm going to see you this weekend at the wedding, so why don't we try and find some time to talk things through then?
Fine.
Suits you, by the way.
What suits me? Good night, Benedict.
Gone. Working late.
Just old bits and pieces, you know.
Martin!
Coming! How do I look?
Like an angel.
See you at the church, then.
See you at the church.
My name's Bergerac. You're a desertranger.
Oh, Bergerac.
That's very sweet.
Bergerac.
Bergerac.
The Bureau des Etrangers, Miss Vale, is a branch of the Jersey Police. I'm sure you know perfectly well.
Now, why on earth should I know
a thing?
Can we get somewhere to talk?
Oh, no, my friend. Don't even think about it. Cover me.
Don't drink too much.
Oh, stony cold sober.
Don't flirt.
I wouldn't dare.
And, you know, if guys start coming up to you and hassling you...
Claude, just... you're jealous.
Yeah, of course I'm jealous. Fiancé's meant to be jealous, isn't
jealous,
he?
Jealous, not insane. I can look after myself. Just trust me, okay?
We are leaving without you.
Mm, 1 minute. Just remember, I love you. Oh, very, very much. And I can't wait to be friends.
What's the forecast?
Oh, it's going to be a beautiful day.
Sorry to interrupt. You forgot this.
Oh, done. Thank you. You saved my life. Look, I've got to run.
Okay.
See ya.
Be good.
I'll try.
Problem?
Sense of humour when they mean sex.
Change the subject, anyone?
He just has this air, like he'd know his way around.
He's global warming.
Enthusiastic, a bit dirty, a laugh.
Maybe it's the way he stares at your breasts when he's talking to you.
I don't mind that. Well, I don't.
Beatrice, your turn. Well, can't we play something different? I know, chess or something.
Come on, play the game.
Otherwise, he's gonna have to do the forfeit.
Yeah.
Fine.
Fine.
Oh!
If you'll excuse me, I just have to make a phone call or something.
Phase two?
Let's do it.
Well, I think it's a crying shame. He loves her so much.
God says it's all he ever talks about. It's the way he looks at her on air that breaks my heart. Such yearning. There's so much love there. Sometimes he says he's talking to her. And it's, you know, all he can do not to just take hold of her and kiss her hard on the mouth. That's what he told Claude anyway.
So why doesn't he just tell her?
Well, there's no point. You know how proud she is. And such an attractive woman too.
Yeah, she is now. But that whole Katharine Hepburn Ice Queen act won't be looking so clever in 5 years' time. If she's not careful, she'll turn into one of those women whose idea of a wild night is a really big tub of hummus.
Margaret?
Have you noticed she's getting these lines, like little bitter wrinkles, like brackets, round her mouth from sneering all the time? Well, if she's so bloody smart, why doesn't she treat him with a bit of respect? Instead of looking down her nose at him all the time, that stuck-up, frigid old cow. Having said all that, I must emphasise that I really do like her tremendously.
Can anyone smell smoke?
Oh, God, she's not in here, is she?
Beatrice, no. I think she went outside for some fresh
coffee. Beatrice, come up, wherever you want.
Ooh, checking for cubicle door.
Let's go, shall we?
Makes sense, I suppose. Maybe I have been a bit too harsh on him. A bit cold, maybe. No reason why I can't be at least civil. After all, people can change, can't they? It is possible. You've changed. I mean, you've shaved. What's happened to your hair?
Oh, just a little dab of product.
Oh, product, right.
Yeah. Do you approve?
Yeah, you look, better.
Well, good.
Are you together?
No. This is Beatrice Evans.
And this is Benedict Taylor.
Yes, I recognise the gentleman from the telly when I was a kid. He used to do the bit between the shows, the mascot, the little toy bunny.
Billy. Billy the Bunny's birthday club. Yes, I've done other stuff since, you know, more serious, journalistic. It's not funny.
Mm-hmm. I have you in adjoining rooms.
Adjoining rooms?
I can put you in different rooms if you'd prefer.
Oh, well, I don't mind it. I mean, there's a lock, isn't there?
I believe so.
Bye then.
Bye.
Are you going down for dinner?
No, I thought I'd just get some room service.
Oh, okay. What were you going to say?
I was going to say... see you in the morning.
Oh, okay. I'll see you in the morning.
Bye then.
Bye.
Night.
Listen, you pay attention to me.
She's very, very
Claude.
Don.
My old mate. Good to see you. How are you?
I need to have a quick word. Can we go somewhere private?
Yeah. You're lying.
If you could just look me down, we could talk this over properly.
There's nothing to talk about because it's all lies.
Just 1 minute.
You must have seen us talking, Claude. At work. You've never noticed us talking.
She feels sorry for you. She gave me these photos. We don't get to see each other very much, so she gives me these. She's written on the back, see? She's She's wearing her swimming costume in this one. Very, very beautiful girl, don't you think?
You stole these. You must have stolen these and forged the writing.
Text messages sent from her phone. This one's on our hen night. I'll be home later. Come and see me. I can't wait. It is a lot to take in, I know. Surprised me too, if I'm honest. I know I'm not a very attractive person. Or lovable. Likeable even, but Hero, she sees something. God knows what, but she sees it. I want you to know that she's always been very, very fond of you. And if you wanted, you could probably still get married. Come with me now to her room. Watch what happens. And then you can make up your own mind.
Well, me.
Oh, right. Come in. Hi. No, I just cleaning my teeth over here in the bathroom.
I'm sorry. I'll come back.
Are you sure I'm not disturbing you?
No, not at all.
This was just something I wanted to ask you. You know, this speech tomorrow, you know, everyone's expecting all kinds of laddie humour and, you know, I just wanted to challenge people's prejudices and read a Shakespeare sonnet instead.
Very original.
Yeah, isn't it? So, I found this poem and, you know, I just wanted to make absolutely sure I understand it, and you're a lot smarter about this sort of stuff than me, so...
Go on.
So I just wanted to say it for you. To you. Is that OK?
Ooh. A poetry recital.
I know. I'm a mass of contradictions. So, you have to promise not to laugh.
Can't promise that.
OK, here goes. Is this a dagger that I see before me? It's a joke. this is the one here. Sonnet 116. Let me not...
To the marriage of true minds admit impediments.
God, you're clever.
It's an echo of the bit in the wedding ceremony. It means, he, the poet, refuses to accept any reason why two people who are...
compatible?
Shouldn't be together.
Love is not love, which alters when it alteration finds.
True love is constant.
Or bends with the remover to remove.
And you can't stop loving somebody just because they stop loving you.
Oh, no! Meaning
Oh, no! It is an ever-fixed
Or you could say fixed. The rhythm, it's iambic.
Fixed. Fixed mark that looks on tempests and is never shaken. It is the star to every wandering bark whose worth's unknown, although his height be taken.
Yes, now, a bark is a ship. It's a seafaring metaphor, navigation. This thing, love, is as constant as the northern star. It's always there, looking over you, no matter how lost you are or how confusing. You look awkward, stood there. Do you want to come and sit over here? Oh, yes, now, this next bit is beautiful. Love's not time's fool, though rosy lips and cheeks within his bending sickle's compass come.
Meaning that, even though we or people in general might get a bit knackered, we or they will still fancy each other.
Well, you're paraphrasing, obviously.
Yeah, I'm paraphrasing. Love alters not with his brief hours and weeks, but bears it out even to the edge of doom.
Till death do us part, the wedding vows.
Exactly.
If this be error and upon me proved, I never writ.
Nor no man ever loved.
Except he did write.
And men have fallen in love before.
So therefore,
Shakespeare must be right.
Exactly.
We should go to bed.
Except I'm already in bed.
So you are. Night. And, you know, sweet sorrow and all that.
Yes. Good night. Benedict. Nice poem.
Sorry, it's just, I've had a bit to drink, and, what with the talk about the wedding and everything, I got to thinking about my ex.
And,
just need to talk to someone just for a minute.
Oh, so this is it? The famous dress.
You don't think it's too much? Beatrice says it makes me look like a snowdrift.
She's just jealous. You are going to look beautiful.
Isn't it, bad luck to see the wedding dress before the big day?
Only if you were marrying me.
There we go.
Let's not tell him I'm here, eh? Don't want him to get the wrong idea.
Hello?
Hello there.
Claude, I thought we agreed.
I know. I just wanted to hear your voice. What are you doing?
Getting ready for bed.
Anyone with you?
Like who?
I mean, Margaret or Beatrice or anyone.
No, I'm by myself.
thinking about you there.
Are you?
Of course I am. Cordy, you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You just sound a little distant. You're not phoning to say the wedding's off or anything like that, are you?
No. No, I was just phoning for the latest forecast, actually.
Oh, I see. Bright sun and clear skies to start. Then clouds starting to form. Patchy shower later.
Rain.
No, don't worry, it won't rain. Beatrice forbids it. And even if it does, we won't let anything spoil our day, will we?
No, of course not.
I'm very happy, Claude.
Me too. I'm very happy too.
Tomorrow then?
Tomorrow.
You're not going like that, are you? Beautiful. Just so beautiful.
Last night, lover boy, keeping me waiting.
How do you mean?
Well, you know how it is. You're in a nice hotel. Had a couple of drinks. Warm, fragrant bath. Your mind starts to wander. Do me up and leave. Hmm? I've come and done again.
Oh.
You know, then, I'm starting to think you don't love me anymore. In fact, I think your affections lie elsewhere.
Okay, if everybody could start taking their places, please.
Sorry, that's my job, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
If I could just have a...
Just give me a minute. One second.
They're on their way.
Mr. Armitage, there have been a number of strange occurrences and we've taken the liberty of jotting them down.
Can this wait, Mr. Berry? I'm about to give away my only child.
No, I understand that. It's just that my deputy, young Vincent here, was on patrol last night and he overheard something. Now, Vince, tell him exactly what you told me.
Sorry, can you start taking your places in the church, please? Bail out at any moment. Give me the word. We'll make a run for it. Is this helping you to relax in any way at all?
You're shaking.
Dear friends, we are gathered here today before the congregation to join together this man and woman in holy matrimony. Marriage is a solemn vow made in the sight of God. Therefore, if any person can show any just cause or impediment why this man and this woman may not lawfully be joined together, let him speak now or forever hold his peace.
I do.
I do comes later, remember?
So we'll just proceed with the service, shall we?
That's right. Bad joke. Carry on.
Right.
No, I'm sorry, but I do know of an impediment. Do you think you want a hero?
No.
What, nothing at all? Come on, think. It's obvious, really.
Stop This piece of cloth.
Okay. Here's a clue. How about lying?
It really isn't.
How about the fact that she's a lying, cheating, scheming, deceitful bitch?
What did you say?
You're here to give her away, Leonard, yes? Is that right?
Yes.
Well, I don't want her. She's rotten goods. Here, you can take it back.
Hey, come on, that's enough.
Look at her. Hey, the blushing bride, all innocent. You'd never guess from that face what a dishonest little tart she really
is. Come here, you!
I don't understand. Why are you doing this?
I know the truth, Hero! I know about the two of you. The secret meetings, the picnics on the beach, the messages, the photographs.
Messages? What photographs?
I saw him go to your room, Hero. I saw you kiss him. I saw you put your arms around him. I was waiting outside. The night before your wedding, Hero?
Who, Don? He's talking about Don.
Sorry, Hero. I had to tell him.
That Don?
Was he or wasn't he in your room last night?
No. I mean, yes. Yes, he came to my room, but just to talk. He said he felt lonely. I felt sorry for him.
Felt sorry for him? Oh, that's a good one. And how many other men have you felt sorry for?
Selfish, Lord, you're being ridiculous.
All right. All right, one more question then. Answer me this. Have you slept with him? Deny it. Go on, here, in church. Please, Hero. I want so much for you to deny it.
Answer him, sweetheart.
I thought you loved me, Claude. If you loved me, you wouldn't do this to me. And you've broken my heart, Claude.
You complete Leonard! Leonard.
She didn't deny it.
Leonard, Leonard.
She didn't deny it.
They've taken her back to the hotel. Try and calm her down. I can't believe I wrote a speech. Generally speaking, no, I think it all went pretty well.
Please,
babe. You're crying.
Yes. And I intend to cry a little longer.
I hate seeing you cry.
Well, don't worry, it's not your fault. Not this time, anyway.
You know, there's nothing in this world I love as much as you. Isn't that strange?
Almost as strange as if I were to say I love you.
Well, I'd been led to believe to hope that perhaps was the case. I love you, Beatrice. There you go. Never said that before. Well, it might have slipped out once or twice, you know, in the heat of the moment. So, but I never thought I'd say it and mean it.
Ben.
I love you so much, Beatrice, that if I can't have you, I think I'm going to go mad.
Then I'm sorry, Benedict.
What are you sorry for, Beatrice?
You've caught me at a very unhappy time. I was about to say I loved you too.
Well, say it then.
I love you so much, I can hardly breathe.
Beatrice, I'll do anything for you, anything you ask, anything. Except for that, maybe?
Why not? I feel like killing him.
Well, yes, but I'm sure he had his reasons.
What reasons? What reasons could he possibly have for humiliating the poor girl like that on her wedding day? What kind of vicious, spiteful... You couldn't have got away from me! Beatrice. On her wedding day! At the altar!
be a man. You're all the same.
Beatrice.
Here he stands spewing out this filth, this poison adherer who's never hurt anyone in her entire life. And what do you all do? You brave, honorable men. You just stand there. Useless. Listening to this slander, these lies. Don't you dare walk away from me when I'm shouting at you!
I love you, Beatrice. And I'm gonna make everything all right.
Ah, there you are. I wonder if I could have a word.
I swear, Mr. Berry, if you ask to see my ID...
Actually, I think we might have an explanation for all this. It'll only take a minute.
I do. And it's nice. Oh! Ladies and gentlemen! Pray silence for the best man!
Claude, you're drunk.
I should bloody hope so. Oh, get stuck in. The boss is paying. Or should I say ex-boss? Hey, if you're hungry, 250 portions of salmon out
there. I need to talk with you. Alone.
Fine. I know when I'm not wanted.
Good. You're not wanted, so go.
No, Don, you stay here. Don. Oh, whoa. What are you going to do? You're going to hit me?
I'm trying hard not to. Claude, you know you've done something terrible, don't you?
Well, see, that, my friend, is a matter of opinion.
You're not my friend, and it's not a matter of opinion. He's tricked you, Claude. He's made you look a fool.
Who, Don? I don't think so. I've seen the proof.
What proof, Claude?
The photos.
He stole them from Hero's room. Mr. Berry here saw him.
That's right, the night of the party.
And the text messages.
He used her phone. He's been borrowing her phone and texting his own number.
What about on her hen night? How did he get her phone then, eh?
He had a bag, remember? He gave it to her in the corridor. I saw him. You were there.
No. This is ridiculous. I saw him go to her room last night. I was there.
In her room?
No, outside, but I saw him...
You saw what you wanted to see, Claude. You saw what he told you to see.
Why would he do all this?
Just so you know, Beatrice is bringing her down now.
Hero, oh, I've got to talk to her.
No, not now, Claude.
No, I need to speak to
her. Not now.
Let go of me or I swear... No, I need to speak to her! Ben, let go of me!
You! I want to talk to you, Don.
Hero, I think I might have made a...
Not now, Claude.
No, I need to say...
I think you said quite enough already, don't you?
He showed me photos,
Hero! I said shut
Hero.
Up! It's him I want to talk to.
I'm all right.
One question. Tell me why, Dom, because I need to understand. Wasn't I kind to you? Affectionate, a good friend? Didn't I listen to you talk on and on into the night? And didn't I tell you the way I felt about you? Wasn't I honest? So tell me, why would you do this to me, Don?
Because I love you. And you humiliated me. And I wanted you to know what that felt like.
Hero, no! Stop!
Oh, sweet. Give him one, please. Give him a hand.
Come away. I'm sorry.
You've got to let go of her. Let her breathe. Call an ambulance.
Ambulance.
It's all right.
Back, everyone, please.
It's all right.
I just want to say that.
Yes.
What is it?
Coffee. Maybe soup.
Thanks, I think I'll pass. Poor old Leonard.
What do we do now?
Just to wait and see what the tests say.
Maybe have a cup of tea or...
Yeah.
Hmm?
It's not good, I'm afraid. She's still not conscious. They're going to do more tests in the morning. And then maybe operate. So I think maybe the best we can do now is just go home and sleep.
Thanks, Pete. Let me take you home.
I'm sorry, Ben.
What for?
We had something to talk about, didn't we? Now doesn't really seem like the right time.
I can wait.
So, here we are. Sorry. I don't know what to say. I thought when I saw you, it would all come flooding out, you know? Some special combination of words would tell you how sorry I am. How much I love you and miss you. But they're not my strong point, are they? Words, they won't do what I want them to. So I'll just have to say that I would happily give my life right now if you'd just open your eyes and say something. Anything, you know, even if it's to say that you hate me. Because if you don't, Hero, I really don't know what I'm going to do.
Sorry, but I'm going to have to ask you to leave. Immediately, please.
Excuse me, is there anyone sitting here?
Well, actually, I'm waiting for a friend.
Would you mind if I sit down while you wait? So, am I late?
Only about 3 years.
I've been offered a job in London. It's just a production job to begin with. Maybe get on screen soon.
You going to take it?
Don't know. It's a big step. Moving away.
I think you should go. Claude, if you're expecting me to forgive you, you're wasting your time.
But I only did it because I loved you.
Funny, that's what Don said. I'm so bored of people using love as an excuse. That's not love anyway, that's just possession. And I'm bored of being owned too by you. By my dad. I'm just gonna look after myself for a while. You know, think things through.
But when you've had some time, maybe you would think about carrying on where we left off?
I'll get married. To you. Never in a million years.
Okay, maybe not in the short term, but sometime in the future, perhaps. Just say I can hope, Hero, please. Please. Love is not love.
Come on. Everyone's waiting.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah.
Okay.
It's all right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Go.
No straw hair?
Yeah, no, it's fine. Okay.
All right.
Have you any idea what confetti actually costs? I swear it'd be cheaper to throw cash. Look at these flowers. Seen for, what, 20 minutes? They chuck them out. You know, I'll tell you, somewhere out there, right now, there is a florist and a caterer having a bloody good laugh.
Shut up, will you? You're making me nervous. Wrong side.
Remind me, what are we doing here?
I have absolutely no idea.
Love is like candy on a shelf. You want to taste and help yourself. The sweetest things are there for you. Help yourself, take a few. That's what I want you to do. Just help yourself to my lips, to my arms. Just say the word and they are yours. Just help yourself to the love in my heart. Your smile has opened up the door. The greatest wealth that exists in the world could never buy what I can give. Just help yourself to my lips, to my arms, and then let's really start to live.